Neuropsychiatric conditions are some of the most severe and devastating conditions that can happen to anyone. At the same time, it's probably the biggest cause of worldwide disability. The ability and thought of being able to treat these or even cure some of these diseases of the mind has been a dream of mine since I was very young.
Eddie's really been doing pioneering work on recording activity from the human brain. And so when he, you know, first heard about this project, he approached me and we started brainstorming about it. And it just sounded like, you know, an opportunity that, you know, I couldn't pass up.
We're here today to discuss an exciting new project that we're about to launch that's a really core part of the new Obama Brain Initiative. The Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, DARPA, has selected us to help study how the brain works and what goes awry in neuropsychiatric conditions. The Center for Neural Engineering and Prosthetics was a collaborative team between UCSF and UC Berkeley.
We both co-direct this Center for Neural Engineering and Prosthesis. My lab conducts research in brain-machine interfaces, which is an interdisciplinary field that basically includes engineering and neuroscience. Brain-machine interfaces is about converting a thought into action. So you can think of this as having an implantable device in the brain. This BMI, brain-machine interface, will translate this neural activity into control commands to drive a prosthetic actuator, like a robotic arm, an exoskeleton. This new project that we're starting uses the same principles, but they are all applied to brain circuits, just only in the brain.
One of our goals is to take brain-machine interfaces to the next level. We want to take this technology to the point where it allows us to understand really complex function of the brain, things like our emotions, our mood. We want to be able to address neuropsychiatric conditions, such as depression, anxiety, post-traumatic stress disorder, chronic pain.
The current state is that we have some treatments, but they're far from perfect.
Medications, for example, can affect the whole body and don't target specific circuits in the brain.
We don't actually know how they work, and that might be fine if they worked great, but they don't.
The idea is to learn how these complicated large-scale brain circuits work, then this BMI should be able to detect this abnormal activity and electrically stimulate in some areas to alleviate these symptoms.
What's really exciting about this project is we're going to look at these disorders and the things in the brain that cause these disorders in a way that no one has ever done before. We know, for example, many of the parts of the brain that are really important and play critical roles in these disorders. But what we don't understand is how these parts of the brain talk to each other and how they interact in ways that contribute to these disorders.
I consider it an enormous responsibility and huge privilege to be part of this project. Almost all of us know someone who's been afflicted by many of these conditions. And I think it's the kind of thing that, as a doctor, I see patients and treat them one by one all the time in my practice. But this is the kind of dream project that allows our science to potentially treat millions of patients that are afflicted with these kind of ailments.